kaneng yang gak ada sih. Hai, everyone, to open your camera. Where are you?
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Okay. How are you today? Can you see my face? Can you guys see my face? I'm down there. I'm down there. Can you see that? It's me waiting.
Yeah.
Alright. So today we are going to try something new. Our lesson today is being broadcasting to a community channel. So if you want to do some review about our lesson today, you just go to our YouTube channel, our school YouTube channel, okay? Is anybody here already? You can open your book, pupil's book. Open our book, pupil's book, page 12. So today we are going to study about showing possession but using apostrophe S. Do you know what the meaning of possessive? Anybody? 12, Naraketa, page 12. So, who knows about what is the meaning of possessive or possession? Can anybody answer that? Anybody answer that? What does it mean by possessive or possession? Erika?
Sorry, Miss, but I cannot hear you clearly.
Excuse me?
Your voice is not clear.
The what?
Your voice.
My voice. Wait.
Is a bit faint, but I can still hear you.
Erika?
Yes,
can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. So everyone. Ah, soalnya kedengaran tapi kecil. Ah, okay. Yeah. Okay, so Erika, could you tell me please what is the meaning of possession or possessive?
don't know.
Ah, okay, anybody knows about that? Is anybody else, does anybody know about what does it mean by possession? Showing possession. Alright, possession means something that belongs to a person or something that belongs to a group or something that belongs to someone. For example, Erica has a new baby sister, right? Erica. So we can say that, and what is name? What is her name?
Danica.
Danica.
Yeah.
I can say that Danica is Erica's sister. It means Danica belongs to Erica. We use possession or possessive to show something that belongs to us or something that belongs to somebody or something that belongs to group. Right. Without further ado, let's take a look to our presentation today. Apostrophe rules for possessive. Rules number one. Use an apostrophe S to show that one person or thing owns or is a member of something. Again, I repeat one more time. Use an apostrophe S. Look at here. This is how we use apostrophe S, the word in the bracket, to show that one person or thing owns or is a member of something. Alright? For example, Lisa's car is new. Lisa's car means that car belongs to Lisa. Okay? Lisa's car is new. Meaning, the new car belongs to Lisa. Number two, Billy's house has a pool. So Billy's house, so the house with a pool belongs to Billy. Example number three, this is Tom's book, meaning that the book belongs to Tom or Tom owns a book. Okay. Any questions so far? Any question? Yeah, if you do not know, you can like put some reaction or you just can tell me on the chat or you just can call my name. Alright. Next. This is the note. Style guide varies when it comes to a name that ends in an S. Even if the name ends in S or letter S, it's still correct to add another S to create the possessive form. It's also acceptable to add only an apostrophe to the end of singular nouns that end in S to make them possessive. Yeah? For example, in this case, you can show possession for Ross in either of two ways. Ross, R-O-S-S, apostrophe room, or Ross, or R-O-S-S, apostrophe S, sports team. So Ross room or Ross's sports team. If there is someone with a name that ending with S, for example, let's say Rika or Ross in this example, You can either put apostrophe S or you just add with S. Okay? For example, like live, L-I-F. You either just put L-I-F apostrophe or you can add L-I-F apostrophe S. Yeah, it doesn't matter. You can choose four of them or you can use four of them. Okay? Next, the rules number two. Use an apostrophe S after BF at the end of a plural noun to show possession. Look at here. If plural noun that end with S, you cannot put another S after the apostrophe. You just put apostrophe and then add by the noun. For example, my parents' bedroom is in the second floor. Or these are student lunch boxes. Meaning, after the plural noun that ending with S, yeah, the plural noun that ending with S, such as parents, students, sisters, brothers, you only add the apostrophe without adding any S. Okay? Remember, if like the note before, like the previous note, it's different with the examples number two or the rules number two. In the previous one, this is an exceptional. So if there is name that ending with S, you either can add only the apostrophe or you just can add apostrophe S. But it's different with this one. It's completely or totally different with this one. It doesn't apply in this plural noun. If the plural noun ending with S, just like this one, parents or students, please only add the apostrophe without the S. Okay? Any question, everyone? Okay, we continue. If you find some difficulties or you don't understand, you just can call my name. Alright? That's the rule number two. Now we are going to study about the rule number three. If a plural noun doesn't end in S, add an apostrophe plus S to create the possessive form. Yeah, in the previous slide, the rules number two, if plural noun that ending with S, you just add by the apostrophe. But if the plural noun doesn't end in S, it's like irregular plural noun, you can add apostrophe S. For example, look at here. Children's playroom, people's toys, men's restroom. Children, plural, people, also plural, men, also plural, but they don't end with S. If the plural noun do not end with S, you have to add apostrophe S. Alright? I hope you guys understand this one. I hope you guys take a little time to absorb this information. Okay? Next. Do we still have next? Oh no. Just stop. Thank you. This is my explanation. Yeah, it's like on your book page 12, but I will make it clearer or more clear in my presentation today. So, any question? Ada pertanyaan enggak? Any question? Okay. If Any question? How about Rahel, any question? No, okay. How about you, Jason? Do you have a question from Stacy? Regardless, regarding to the lesson today? Any question, everyone? Before I continue to give you some exercises. Okay, what is the question? Okay. Christy, any question?
No,
ma'am. No. Kevin? Any question, ma? No. Okay. Kenzo? Nico?
No, ma'am.
No. Joshua?
No,
ma'am. No? Okay. Naraseta? Any question? Naraseta, any question?
No.
No? Right. Okay. Angel?
No.
No. Freya?
No, ma'am.
No. Right. Arvin? Sorry. Jeffkai?
No, ma'am.
Revan?
No, ma'am.
Jaron?
No, ma'am.
Email?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Because you guys, your answer is no, so I'll give you some exercise today. Okay. Please take your exercise book. Take your exercise book. Take your exercise book. Yeah. Ready? I will give you some words and I will ask you to make some sentences. Okay, number one. Number one, title for me is happy. Number one, title for me is happy. Happy, but in a plural form. P-U-P-P-I-E-S. Happy. Number two. Word number two. Cool. 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 S-C-H-O-O-L. Good. Yep.
Bisa diulangi yang satu, soalnya tadi
yang okay, number one is happy.
Happy.
Happy. P-U-P-P-I-E-S. Happy. Okay, number two is school. Number two is school. S-C-H-O-O-L. Number three. Okay, number three. Number three is book. Number three, book. Okay. Number four, boys. Boys, B-O-Y-S. Okay. Alright, number five. Alright, for everyone who are watching this live streaming, don't forget to like and subscribe. Alright, number six is house. Okay, can you repeat number one? What is number one? What is the word number one? What is the word number one? Everyone? Tolong diulangi tadi kata-kata yang nomor satu itu apa? Halo? What is the word number one? Hah? Tadi kata nomor satu apa? Kata yang pertama tadi apa nomor satu? Number one apa? Hey guys, I'm talking to you. Come on, it's late. Keep some response.
It wasn't clear, mom.
Huh?
It wasn't clear. I couldn't hear.
I'm only asking you what is the word number one. Miss gak minta kalimatnya. Miss cuma tahu. Mau confirm aja kalian dengar nggak suaranya Miss Daisy. So ah yes, happy, good. Number two. Number two is cool. Cool. C-S-C-H-O-O-L. Cool. And can you tell me what is number three? What is the word number three? Ini nanti kata-kata ini bukan listening and dictation loh ya. Ini nanti kalian membuat kalimat menggunakan apostrophe S to show some to show possession. So number one puppies, number two school, number three is Erika. What is the word number three? Angel.
Yang saya dengar itu book.
Apa? Book. With S ya. Plural. Number four.
Boys.
Good job. The last one. What is the last one? What is the last word? How? Okay. So everyone here, I need you to make sentences from those words. Yeah, from puppies, school, book, boys, and house. Right? Regarding to our discussion today, you have to make sentences just like this example. Yeah, like Lisa's car is new, Billy's house has a pool, this is some book. But I need you to make sentences consist more than five words. Understand? Because you already grade 6, you need to upgrade yourself. Please don't make sentences under five words. Alright? For example, like Billy's house has a pool, or minimum five, like the sentence number two. Billy's house has a pool. Billy's house has a pool. So five words minimum. Okay? After this, I need you to read your sentences to me. Is 10 minutes enough for you guys to make sentences? It's only 5. It's only 5. So me, 1 minute, one sentence. Alright? Remember, one sentence consists minimum 5 words. Just like the example number 2. But I hope, or I expect you make more than 5 words. I know you can do that. Don't hesitate to give me some question, yeah? Kamu ngerti nggak sayang? Kevin. Kevin dengar musisi nggak? Kevin. Kevin dengar musisi nak?
Ya, Miss.
Kamu dengar di Jessie, kan?
Dengar, maaf, Tad. Soalnya rumahku udah sama ada kereta api, jadinya ya aku gak dengar suara Mam Daisy.
Oke. Ada yang mau ditanyakan gak? Udah ngerti gak penjelasan dari Miss Jessie tadi? Perlu diulang? It's okay. Kevin, I'm talking to you, nak. Okay, tell me if you are done.
Hey guys, you need... One. It's only 5 sentences. How about you, Nico? Are you done?
Not yet.
Not yet, okay. Christy, are you done?
Done.
Done? Alright, let's start with Christy. Christy, I need you to speak louder than this. Alright?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ternyata not yet.
Who's not yet? Christy then?
Not yet.
Oh, I thought you are done. Kenzo, how about you? Are you done? Kenzo?
Not yet, ma'am.
Not yet, okay. Erica?
I'm also not done.
Huh?
I'm not done.
Okay. Okay. So this is very simple actually. It's like we use this in daily conversation. Like I always said, or I sometimes ask you about whose book is this? Oh, this is Erica's book, or this is Simon's pen, or this is Nico's presentation, something like that. Okay? Don't think too hard, just make it a simple one. Or the name ending with S, it's either you put only apostrophe or you can add apostrophe S. It doesn't matter which one. Jadi kalau misalkan ada orang yang namanya berakhiran dengan huruf S, jadi boleh ditambah pakai S, apostrophe S, atau apostrophe saja. So it doesn't matter. It's up to you. Both of them are acceptable. You are welcome. Kevin?
Yes, ma'am.
Ya, Kevin mengerti apa yang Jessy jelaskan tadi?
Yang ma'am jelaskan?
Ya.
Not yet.
Huh?
Not yet.
No, I'm not asking you are you done or not. I'm asking you, do you understand with my explanation? Apakah Kevin mengerti dengan penjelasan dari Miss Jessy tadi?
No, maksudnya kayak gimana maksudnya?
Okay. Do you want me to repeat the explanation? That's why Miss Desi tadi tanya, Kevin sudah mengerti belum? Kevin bilang, oh iya, tidak ada pertanyaan. Kalau tidak ada pertanyaan, berarti kamu sudah mengerti loh, nak.
Itu tadi salah ngomong, bukan. Iya.
Oke, Kevin, perhatikan ya. Perhatikan di screen. Kalau kamu tidak dengar, if you couldn't hear my voice, you can stop me. Jadi kamu bisa hentikan Miss Jessie dan bilang, Miss, aku nggak dengar suaranya Miss Jessie, gitu ya. Ya, oke. Okay. Listen carefully, Kevin. Today's lesson is about apostrophe rules for possessive. Jadi kita akan belajar hari ini tentang kepemilikan terhadap sesuatu, entah itu binatang, entah itu benda, ya, kepemilikan. Kevin paham nggak maksudnya kepemilikan? Kepemilikan itu artinya seseorang yang memiliki sesuatu. Contohnya, Kevin punya pensil di situ. Show me your pen or pencil. Show me your pencil. Show me your pencil. So, and if I'm asking you whose pencil is that? Pensilnya siapa itu? Pensilnya siapa itu? Yang kamu pegang itu pensilnya siapa? Kevin?
Ya.
Yang kenceng jawabnya, nak. Pensilnya siapa? Whose pencil is that? Mic-nya jangan dimatikan dulu, sayang. Tetap dinyalakan aja. Biar kita komunikasinya enak. Kamu gak usah matikan, nyalain, oke? Okay? Turn on your mic now, oke. Okay. Whose pencil is that? The pencil with in on your in your hand, itu punya siapa?
Punya aku.
Siapa? Sebutkan namanya. Punya siapa?
Kevin.
Nah, berarti pencil ini punya Kevin. Kevin memiliki pensil itu, betul? Benar ya? Itu namanya kepemilikan. Nah, kepemilikan dalam bahasa Inggris itu namanya possessive atau possession. Paham, Kevin? Kepemilikan artinya kamu memiliki sesuatu atau benda ini dimiliki oleh seseorang. Contohnya dalam kasus ini, Kevin memiliki pensil. Jadi pensil ini dimiliki oleh Kevin. Paham? Nah, kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia gampang. Dia cuma bilang pensil merah ini adalah milik Kevin atau kepunyaan Kevin. But in English somehow we use apostrophe. Nah, apostrophe ini artinya apa? Apostrophe itu koma atas, tapi koma satu. Kan kalau koma dua itu untuk memulai percakapan, ya, dialog, koma dua, tanda petik. Nah, kalau apostrofi ini adalah tanda petik tapi cuma satu. Paham ya, Kevin? Ya, jadi untuk menunjukkan kepemilikan dalam bahasa Inggris, salah satunya adalah menggunakan apostrofi atau koma atas. Oke, bisa dilanjut. So, there are some rules, ada beberapa aturan bagaimana menggunakan apostrofi ini. Oke, okay? Ada aturan bagaimana how we use this apostrophe S. Yang pertama, the rules number one. Use an apostrophe plus S, seperti yang ada dalam kurung, to show that one person or thing owns or is a member of something. Ya, jadi apostrofi ini menunjukkan kepemilikan atau seseorang memiliki sesuatu atau termasuk atau kelompok dari sesuatu. Contoh. Oke ya, perhatikan ya kayak gini ya. Lisa's car is new. Lisa's car is new. Bisa nggak Kevin terjemahkan ini dalam bahasa Indonesia bagaimana? Hah?
Mobil Lisa itu
yes,
baru.
Yes, you mean. Hah? Gimana Kevin?
Mobil Lisa itu baru.
Ya, bukan mobil Lisa, mobilnya Lisa itu baru. Ya, jadi kalau mau dibilang gampangnya, kalau misalkan bukunya Kevin, nah apostrofi S itu menggantikan nya. Kalau bukunya Kevin, kita bisa bilang Kevin's book. Rumahnya Kevin, Kevin's house. Ya, jadi kalau dalam kalimat ini Lisa's car is new, meaning mobilnya Lisa itu baru. Paham ya, Kevin ya? Oke, kalimat nomor 2. Billy's house has a pool. Can you translate it into bahasa? Kevin?
Yes, ma'am.
Boleh diterjemahkan ke dalam bahasa Indonesia? Kalimat nomor 2. Billy's house has a pool.
Rumah Billy mempunyai kolam renang.
Ya, rumahnya Billy punya kolam renang. Good job. Number 3, this is Tom's house.
Ini punya ini punyanya bukunya Tom.
No, this is Tom's book, meaning ini adalah bukunya Tom. Gitu ya. Oke. Ini rules pertama, menyatakan kepemilikan benda atau sesuatu untuk seseorang ya. Berikutnya, ini penjelasan yang tadi ditanyakan oleh kalau nggak Angel Naraseta. Bagaimana kalau ada orang yang namanya berakhiran dengan huruf S? Misalkan apa ya kok dalam bahasa Indonesia? Misalkan Rose. Ini sih kalau dalam contoh ini adalah Rose. Nah, Rose ini hurufnya kan namanya kan R-O-S-S, R-O-S-S, ending with S. Dalam kasus ini, ya, anak-anak boleh menambahkan hanya apostrofi saja atau koma atas saja, or you can add apostrofi S. Either way are correct. Dua-duanya betul. Ya. Jadi kalau ada nama yang berakhiran dengan huruf S, bisa pakai koma atas saja atau bisa juga pakai koma atas dan S. Oke, Kevin? Oke. Lalu berikutnya, rule number 2. Use an apostrophe after DS at the end of a plural noun to show possession. Nah, kalau yang tadi-tadi itu kata bendanya cuma satu. Nah, ini kata bendanya lebih dari satu, tapi plural noun-nya yang irregular. Nah, kalau biasanya plural noun itu biasanya kan ditambahin S, IS, atau IES. Tapi ada plural noun yang disebut dengan irregular plural noun, artinya berubah bentuk katanya. Contoh, child. Misalkan kalau anaknya cuma satu, we said a child. Tapi kalau anaknya banyak, kita bilangnya children. Nah, children di sini, ini kan bentuknya plural ya. Nah, maka, sorry, itu yang nomor tiga. Yang nomor dua ini, kelewatan. Yang nomor dua itu maksudnya, kalau ada kata benda yang berakhiran dengan S, itu nggak usah ditambahin S lagi setelah apostrofi. Contohnya, my parents. Parents itu plural karena ada S di belakangnya. Jadi hanya ditambah apostrofi saja, Kevin. Ya, tidak ditambah S lagi. Paham, Kevin? Kalau kata bendanya lebih dari satu dan ada S di belakangnya, Maka setelah kata S itu hanya perlu ditambahkan apostrofi saja. You just add the apostrophe without adding S. For example, my parents' bathroom is in the second floor. These are students' lunch boxes. Jadi pakai setelah parents hanya koma atas saja, tidak perlu ditambahin S lagi. Demikian juga dengan students, tidak perlu ditambahin S, hanya apostrofi saja. Apostrofi itu apa tadi, Kevin? Apostrofi tadi apa?
Apa, Miss?
Apostrofi itu apa?
Gak ada, gak sedikit putus.
Apostrofi itu apa?
Atau?
Apostrofi. Apostrofi itu apa? Apostrofi itu koma atas. Ulang lagi. Apostrofi itu apa?
Koma.
Koma atas. Koma yang tempatnya ada di atas. Kan koma ada yang di bawah, ada yang di atas. Nah, kalau yang di bawah namanya koma, kalau yang di atas itu namanya apostrofi. Oke, Miss Desi tanya lagi. Koma yang di atas itu namanya apa, Kevin?
Atas.
Namanya apa? Ini apa ini?
Apostrofi.
Ya, apostrofi. Good. Jadi apostrofi tadi apa? Koma?
Atas koma.
Koma atas, bukan atas koma. Koma atas. Jadi ulang lagi. Apostrofi adalah?
Koma atas.
Ya, untuk menunjukkan apa?
Atau top.
No, apostrofi is to show you what?
Kenapa?
Apostrofi itu kegunaannya apa? Menunjukkan apa, Kevin? Kepemilikan. Lagi bisa ditanya. Apostrofi itu menunjukkan apa? Untuk menunjukkan apa?
Kepemilikan.
Ya. Apostrofi, yaitu koma atas, ditambah S, itu menunjukkan kepemilikan. Oke, Kevin? Ya, next. Rules yang ketiga. If a plural noun doesn't end in S, kalau ada kata jamak, kata benda bentuk jamak yang tidak berakhiran dengan S, ditambahkan apostrofi plus S untuk menciptakan bentuk kepemilikan. To create the possessive form. Ini yang tadi Miss Desi bilang, kalau ada kata benda tapi yang tidak berakhiran dengan S, tetap harus ditambahkan dengan apostrofi S. Ya, tadi kalau kata bendanya berakhiran dengan S kan ditambahkan koma atas saja. Tapi kalau ini plural noun yang bentuknya berubah dari singular ke plural, dari child ke children, person ke people, itu kan children, people, men, itu kan bentuknya plural, bentuknya jamak. Jamak itu maksudnya bendanya lebih dari satu. Ini kan tidak berakhiran dengan S kan, tetap harus ditambahkan apostrofi S untuk menyatakan kepemilikan. Jadi children's playroom, jadi tempat bermainnya anak-anak. People's choice, jadi pilihan orang-orang. Men's restroom, jadi kamar mandi atau restroomnya laki-laki gitu. Nah, laki-lakinya lebih dari satu. Oke, okay. Ada pertanyaan, Kevin? Ada yang masih bingung yang
Miss,
mau ditanyakan?
Miss, sebentar dulu.
Hah?
Sebentar dulu, Miss. Mau itu dulu.
Mau apa?
Mau ke kamar mandi.
Oke. Okay. Okay, how about the other? Are you done, guys? Siapa yang sudah? Who's finished? Come on. Don't miss our time. We already 30 to 35 minutes left. Let's go. Who's done? Come on, everyone. Angel, are you done? It's more than 10 minutes loh. Jadi sudah hampir 20 menit ini. Let's go. It's only 1:17. Come on. My grade 3 students can do this over 10 minutes. Let's go. Ayo anak-anak, siapa yang sudah? Anak-anak dengar Jessy nggak sih? Dengar suaranya Jessy nggak?
Dengar, Mam.
Nah, come on, give some response. I'm not talking to the wall, right? Come on, let's go. Siapa yang sudah?
Aku udah.
Who is that? Nico.
Nico.
Come on, let's hear your sentences. Slow down. Let's go, Nico.
Number one, puppy.
Puppy.
Puppy is
not,
very big.
Nico, Nico. It's not puppy, but puppy. Okay.
Tom puppies is very big.
Wait, bentar, bentar. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Wait a second. Bentar. Yo, aku udah matikan musiknya nih. Gimana? Gimana itu? Oh. Anak, tunggu sebentar ya. Wait a second ya. Alright. Okay, Nico. Come on.
Tom puppies is very big.
Huh?
Tom puppies is very big.
Tom?
Puppies.
Okay, Tom's puppies. You know puppies is more than one, right? So, supposed to be Tom, Tom's puppies are, or Tom's puppies is. Ha, Nico? Puppies is plural noun. Puppies is plural noun. It's more than one. So, Tom's puppies are very big, or Tom's puppies is very big. So which one is the correct one?
Tom's puppies are very big.
Yeah, Tom's puppies are very big. Good job. Next.
Number two, school. Today is Monday and it's time for schools.
Possessive-nya di mana? Which one is...
Time?
Possessive-nya mana? Which one is showing us possessive? Possession.
Suaranya memang kurang jelas di sini.
Oke, yang mana dari kalimatmu itu yang menunjukkan possession? Which one in your sentence which
schools
shows possession?
Schools.
How's that in bahasa? I don't get it. Can you repeat your sentence one more time? Can you repeat your sentence, Nico? Can you repeat your sentence, please?
Today is Monday and it's time for schools.
Today
is Monday and it's time for schools.
Aduh, masih enggak dengar juga nih. Can you repeat one more time? Slow down, pelan-pelan. Apa nak?
Today is Monday and it's time for schools.
Ah, today is Monday and it's time for school. No, it's not like that. Or you can select this. Today is Monday. It's school time. Ah, bisa ya. It's school time or it's time. It's school time. Ini waktunya sekolah. Or no, it's not like that. It's school time. No. It can be like this. Stranger cannot enter school's property. Jadi orang asing tidak bisa masuk ke area sekolah. Bisa. Ya, so strangers cannot enter school's property. Baru bisa. Oke, okay, next sentence.
Tommy love reading books because it's fun.
Tommy loves reading books because
it's fun.
Posesifnya di mana?
Apa?
Posesifnya di mana? Possessionnya di mana? Yang menunjukkan possession di mana? Di kata apa?
Booksnya.
These are Tom's books. These are Tom's book collection. Baru bisa. Bukunya Tom. Tom's book. Jadi book di sini itu bukan plural yang Miss Jessie kasih tadi itu. Books itu di situ adalah bukan possession. Books yang Miss Jessie kasih kata-katanya tadi itu adalah tentang plural noun. Jadi kalau kamu pakai kata yang pertama atau kalimat yang pertama, it's not quite suitable with our material today. So it's not showing us any possession. Jadi salah satunya, maksudnya kata-katanya harusnya seperti ini. These are Tom's books collection. Jadi ini adalah koleksi buku-bukunya Tom. Ah, kayak gitu. Oke. Okay. Jadi kalau diterjemahkan ke dalam bahasa Indonesia itu bukunya, rumahnya, anjingnya, sekolahnya, apalagi rumahnya, sepatunya, bajunya, kata-katanya. Nah, seperti itu harus ada nyanya. Ya, oke, okay, next Nico.
Boys ya. The boys car is are expensive.
Hah? Can you repeat?
The boys car are expensive.
The boys car. Ya.
Yeah.
Yeah, good job. The boys cars. The boys cars are expensive. Car-nya itu harus singular karena punya orang atau punya anak laki-laki yang lebih dari satu. The boys cars are expensive. Good job. Next Nico.
House John will buy a new houses next month.
Posisinya di mana?
Houses.
Houses di situ plural.
Oh.
Oke, Jason. You can. Houses di kamu yang kalau berdasarkan kalimatnya Nico itu adalah plural noun, bukan possessive noun. Oke, apa lagi? Jadi kalau houses, house kan?
Iya.
House. Lily's house is near our school. Nah, itu baru bisa. Lily's house or like Kenzo's house is near our school. Itu bisa. Jadi rumahnya entah Lily, entah Kenzo itu dekat dengan sekolah. Nah, kalau yang tadi kamu bilang, what is your sentence again?
Ma'am.
What is your sentence again?
John will buy a new house.
Buy a new house. Jadi John akan membeli rumah baru. Mananya yang menunjukkan kepemilikan? Dia itu hanya menyatakan bahwa oh ya John itu akan beli rumah baru. That's it. Kamu bisa bilang that new house is John's. Rumah baru itu punyanya John. Itu baru bisa. Tapi kalau kalimatnya Nico yang pertama itu adalah hanya statement biasa, tidak menunjukkan possessive atau possession, ya. Wait, wait a second. House is the last word, right, Nico? Oke, jadi anak-anak masih ada yang belum paham ya. Ini menunjukkan kepemilikan. Kalau seperti yang kalimat yang Miss Jessy, kata-kata yang Miss Jessy berikan untuk anak-anak membuat kalimat, contohnya puppies. Nah, kalian harus menyatakan bahwa sesuatu yang punyanya puppies atau puppies itu dimiliki oleh siapa? Contohnya, kalau dari Miss Jessy contohnya seperti ini. The puppy's fur, bulunya anak anjing itu, the puppy's fur is soft and fluffy. Jadi bulunya anak-anak anjing itu lembut dan lembut dan apa fluffy itu empuk gitu, ya. Atau seperti yang punya Nico tadi, Tom's puppies are very big. Jadi puppies itu entah memiliki sesuatu atau dimiliki oleh seseorang, gitu loh. Nah, kalau house gimana? House itu berarti misalkan Jake's house, rumahnya Jake. Jake's house has two master bedrooms. Jadi rumahnya Jake punya dua kamar tidur utama, seperti itu. Or this house's glass is so wide. Atau kacanya rumah ini itu lebar sekali atau luas sekali, gitu bisa. Gitu loh. Jadi menyatakan kepemilikan sebenarnya. Entah misalkan kalau rumah berarti rumah itu memiliki sesuatu atau rumah itu dimiliki oleh seseorang. Something like that. Okay. Thank you, Nico. Who's next? Who's next? Let's go. Thank you, Nico. You are doing great. Everyone? Hello?
Saya mau nyoba, Bang.
Oh, Erica or Angel? You are... Talk to me at the same time. So, Angel or Erica?
Angel, Bang.
Huh?
Angel.
Angel. Let's go, darling. Let's go.
Yang pertama,
puppies. Number one, it's not yang pertama, the first is?
The first is puppies. That are Melissa puppies.
Those are?
Melissa's puppies.
Good job. Those are Melissa's puppies. Good. Next.
Number two, school.
School, this, yes.
Okay. The school was owned by S. mother.
Huh? Can you repeat one more time?
This school was owned by S. mother.
This school was or is?
Was.
Okay, this school owned or was owned by
S. mother.
Whose father?
S. Pakai A-S-H.
Oh, S. S. father, ya?
Mother.
Oh, mother. Okay, that's good. Next, Angel, number 3.
That's my friend's book.
So then you say, that's my friend's book. Is that correct? Okay, good job. Next.
The boys have couple of books.
The boys have
couple of books.
Purple. The boys what? The boys have couple of
books.
Ah, possessionnya di mana? Possessionnya di mana? Where is the possession? Which one is showing you the possession? The boys what? After that, it has to be followed by noun. Setelah boys apostrophe s, itu harus diikuti oleh kata benda. The boys what? The boys apa? Can be the boys the boys basketball team is great, misalkan gitu. Jadi tim basketnya anak laki-laki itu bagus gitu. Jadi after this one must be followed by noun. Gitu. The boys what? The boys house, the boys uniform, the boys bike, the boys English grade, or the boys English mark are good. Gitu, ya. Oke. Ulangi lagi, Angel. Yang the boys part. Let's go. The boys.
The boys' book are good.
The boys' books are
good.
Huh? The boys' books are The boys' books are what? Thick, above, thick, old. The boys' books are torn. Bukunya anak-anak itu robek. Bisa. So which one?
The boys' books are lucky.
The boys' books are?
Dirty.
So what is that? Yeah, good job. Excellent. That's great. The boys' books, ini pakai S loh ya harusnya. The boys' books are dirty. Okay. Next.
Emily's house is in the middle of the city.
Emily's house is in the middle of the city. Good job. Good job, Angel. Excellent ya. Okay. Thank you, Angel. Who's next? Let's go. Erika. Let's go, baby.
Puppies. The puppy's mother found a shelter.
The puppy's mother
found a shelter.
Excuse me? The puppy's mother is?
Found a shelter.
The puppy's mother found a shelter?
Yeah.
Okay, good job. Next.
School. Tom's school is near my house.
Tom's school is near my house. Good job. Next.
Anne's books were given to the library.
Yeah. Anne's books were given to the library. Excellent. Next.
These are the boys' toys.
Okay. These are the boys' toys. Yeah.
House. My brother's house is huge.
Okay. Good job. Very well. Good job. That's a good example. Who's next? Kevin sudah?
Kenapa, Mem?
Kevin sudah?
Sudah apa?
Sudah buat kalimat.
Kalimat apa?
Oke, skip. Axel, kamu sudah belum?
Belum, Mem.
Oke, Christy, how about you?
Done, Mem.
Done? Yeah, somebody please text Kevin what he should do. Tolong seseorang text Kevin, chat Kevin, kasih tahu apa yang harus dia kerjakan ya. Christy, let's go.
Number one, puppy. There are so much puppies in your house.
Wait, excuse me. There are lots of puppies in your house. Kepemilikannya di mana, nak?
Putus-putus, ma'am.
Okay, you said that there are lots of puppies in that house. Is that correct? Christy?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you repeat your sentence, please?
There are many puppies in your house.
There are many puppies in your house. Yang menunjukkan possession yang mana?
Mem.
Mana kata-kata yang menunjukkan possession atau kepemilikan di kalimat kamu barusan? Christy, can you hear me?
Suaranya kecil, ma'am.
Oke, dari kata-katanya Christy barusan, mana yang menunjukkan possession atau kepemilikan di kalimat kamu barusan? Karena itu nggak ada kepemilikannya, nggak ada apostrofi S-nya, Christy. Kamu hanya menyatakan, oh di rumah itu, di rumah kamu ada banyak, di sana ada banyak anak-anak, ada banyak anak-anak anjing di rumah itu. Nah, terus kepemilikannya siapa? Anjingnya memiliki siapa atau dimiliki siapa? Tidak ada di situ. Hah? Christy? Ayo, let's go. Gimana? You can say these are my brother's puppies. Or the puppies feet are hurt by thorn, misalkan. Jadi harus menunjukkan bahwa sesuatu itu dimiliki oleh anjing itu, anak-anak anjing itu, atau anak-anak anjing itu dimiliki oleh seseorang. Itu baru bisa. These are my brother's puppies. Gitu. Oke, Christy. Number two.
Number two, school. Today is your school times. School's time.
Oke. Let me rephrase that. Let me rephrase that. Today is Christy's school time. Tuh, baru oke. Okay. Ya. Lebih tepatnya di situ. So today is Christy's school time. Number 3, Christy.
There are so many books in my brother's library.
Yeah. There are many books in my brother's library. Itu baru benar. Okay, next.
Boys. The boys like playing soccer.
The boys like to play soccer. Posisinya enggak ada. You can say like this. Soccer is the boys' favorite. The boys' favorite game. Itu bisa. Soccer is the boys' apostrophe favorite game. Okay, Christy. Soccer is the boys' B-O-Y-S apostrophe favorite game. Itu baru bisa. Next, house.
Number 5, house. In Jenny's house has a lot of books.
Yeah, good job. In Jenny's house, there is lots of food. Gitu. Or Jenny's house has lots of food. Boleh. Okay, thank you, Christy. Next. Sudah ada yang text ke Kevin belum? Udah ada yang kasih tau Kevin belum? Dia harus ngapain?
Kenapa, Mi?
Kamu sudah tahu harus ngapain, Kevin?
Iya, lagi tanda jawaban.
Hah?
Iya, lagi tanda jawaban.
Oke. Okay. Kenzo, are you done? Oke. Let's go now. Your mic. Kenzo. Kenzo.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, your turn.
Papi. In Justin's house, he had an army of puppies.
Hey, in Jesse's house, Jesse's ya?
Yeah.
In Jesse's house,
he had an army of puppies.
Oh, nice. Okay, next.
School. In the work days, we go to school.
In what?
Work days.
What is that?
Semacam Senin, Selasa, Rabu, Kamis, Jumat. Work days.
Posisinya di mana, nak?
In the work days, we go to schools.
Can you type it in the chat, on the chat? In the work days, we go to schools. No, school di situ, setelah schools itu harusnya it's supposed to followed by noun. Jadi either this is Tom's school or we cannot use school's properties or school's tools without permission. Itu bisa. Okay, Freya, you may. Yeah. Ganti ya, Kenzo ya. Because it's not suitable with our lesson today. Okay, Kenzo? Kenzo?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next.
Book. The book at the shelf is mine.
The book at what?
At the shelf.
The book at the shelf?
It's mine.
It's mine, okay. Kita belum belajar sampai possession di kesana. Belum sampai ke proses, possessive pronoun, belum ya. Kita masih pakai apostrophe. Jadi, can you change it into sentence with the possessive with the apostrophe s? The book in this shelf, it's mine. Gimana? Harus diganti itu. Kita belum menginjak ke possessive pronoun. Or you can say the books in this shelf or the book in this shelf are my brother's book or the books in this shelf are my father's book. Bisa seperti itu. Next, Kenzo. Next word, Kenzo.
Boy. This pencil, the owner of this pencil is that boy.
This is that boy's pencil. This is that boy's pencil. Harus that boy's pencil. Setelah apostrophe S, follow atau diikuti oleh kata benda. Kalau kalimat Kenzo yang baru saja itu tidak menyatakan kepemilikan dengan menggunakan apostrophe S, gitu ya. This is that boy or that boy pencil, baru bisa kayak gitu. Okay, next, house.
House. I see a new house in the street that is going to be Nico house.
What is the last part? What is the
I last see a new house in the street that is going to be Nico houses.
Good job. That's going to be Nico house. Nico's house. Okay, good job. Thank you, Kenzo. Okay. Naraseta, how about you?
Aku sudah mempunyai agak ragu.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Let's discuss it together. Let's go. Let's go.
Juliet and Amelia are Jane's puppies.
Amelia and?
Juliet and Amelia are Jane's puppies.
Ah, good. Next. Oh, the name of the dog is Julia and Amelia?
Are Jane's puppies.
Oh, wow. Nama anjingnya bagus ya. Okay, next. Next.
School. Jake's school has a fish pond.
Jake's school has
a fish pond.
A space?
Fish pond.
Okay. Okay, fish pond. Okay, next. Very good. Next, Naraseta.
This team school.
This what?
This team school. This team itu nama, terus books-nya itu
book. Oh, this is team's book, gitu maksudnya?
Iya.
Ah, okay. Next.
boys. The boys' watches were stolen.
The boys?
Watches were stolen.
The boys' watch? The boys' watches?
Were stolen.
Were stolen?
Yes.
Ah, the boys' watches were stolen. Good. Next.
House. My parents has expensive house.
My parents' house is an expensive house.
My parents has expensive house.
Mm-hmm. My parents' house is an expensive house. That's the correct one. It's not like my parents have an expensive house. Enggak ada possessionnya di situ. Possession yang pakai apostrophe S. The correct one is my parents' house is an expensive house. Itu baru oke. Okay. Okay, Narasita?
Amen.
Okay, thank you so much for your effort, darling. Thank you so much. Okay. Rahel, are you there? Where is Rahel?
Yes, ma'am.
Rahel, it's not Revan. Rahel, where is Rahel? Does she left?
Rahel itu internetnya, ma'am.
Hah?
Internetnya Rahel itu belum sama.
Okay. Freya, how about you? Freya done. Let's go, Freya.
Bobby's toy is cheap.
Huh?
That Bobby's toy is cheap.
The what? The...
That Bobby's toy is cheap.
The puppy's toy?
Is cheap.
Is cheap. The puppy's toy or toys?
Toy.
Toy. The puppy's toy is cheap. Okay. Next. Yes, Saraseta.
The school's playground is really big.
Huh?
The school's playground is really big.
Good job. Next.
Book. There are lots of books in the library.
There are?
Lots of books in the library.
Can you slow down? There are
lots of books in the library.
Oh, there are lots of books in the library.
Yeah.
The school's library has lots of books. Itu baru bisa. Yeah.
No, it's not like this library has lots of books.
Huh?
That boy's hat is blue.
No. Still go back in the book. Kita masih membahas tentang book. Kalau kalimatnya Freya apa tadi sebelumnya?
There are a lot of books in the library.
There are lots of books in the library. Itu tidak ada possessionnya, nah. Tidak ada yang menunjukkan possession. Or we can say the school's library, perpustakaannya sekolah, the school's library, our school's library has lots of books. Itu baru bisa. Okay, Freya?
Yeah.
Okay, next.
That boy's hat is blue.
That?
Boy's hat is blue.
That boy's hat? That boy's hat is
blue.
Good. G-O-O-D. Good.
There are lots of houses in this neighborhood.
There are lots of houses in the neighborhood. Posisinya di mana?
Houses.
No. Houses yang kamu bilang di situ itu plural noun. There are a lot of houses. Itu plural noun, bukan possession. or you can say these neighborhood houses, rumah, perumahan di lingkungan ini itu sangat besar atau sangat banyak enggak? These neighborhood houses are so big, itu baru bisa. These neighborhood houses are expensive, itu baru bisa. Oke, okay, Freya?
Iya, ma'am.
Oke, okay, please diperbaiki ya. Next is Simon. Simon, are you there? Simon. Oh, the left. Revan.
Yes, ma'am.
Revan, let's hear your sentences.
The puppies belong to my dad.
The puppies belongs to
my dad.
These are my dad's, my father's puppies. Itu baru bisa. These are my father's puppies. Itu baru benar. Okay, next. School.
Bob read his book in English.
Huh?
Bob's read his book in English.
Bob what?
Bob read his books in English.
Bob keep his book in his house, gitu maksudnya?
Ya.
Oh, possession-nya di mana? Bob's books scatter on the floor. Buku-bukunya Tom berserakan di lantai. Bob's books scatter on the floor. Itu baru benar. Jadi buku-bukunya Bob berserakan di lantai. Okay, next. Number 3, Revan.
Annie went to school yesterday.
Alice?
Went to school yesterday.
Oh. Gak ada possessionnya di situ, nak. Or you can say yesterday was our school's anniversary, itu baru bisa. Ulang tahunnya sekolah kita. Yesterday was our school's anniversary. Itu baru bisa. Ya, menyatakan kepemilikan bahwa sekolah ini punya hari ulang tahunnya sendiri. Oke, okay, next. Number 3.
Andy's house near the hospital.
Okay, good. Next.
The boy's house is heavy.
The boy's house is
heavy.
Easy. The boy's house is
heavy.
What is that?
Berat.
Rumahnya berat.
Iya.
Ruh. Emang rumah bisa diangkat, nak? Nggak bisa dong. Ya. Jadi nggak bisa di. Secara logika nggak masuk itu. Jadi the boy's house it's either expensive or small or big or cheap, tapi nggak pernah berat gitu. Karena nggak pernah diangkat rumah itu gitu loh. Paham ya? Or the boy's bags are heavy, itu baru benar. Karena kamu pasti ngangkat tas kan? Oke, okay, Revan.
Yes, ma'am.
Next. Next. Selanjutnya apa? Sudah? Revan, sudah ya?
Sudah.
Oke, okay, thank you. Darren?
Lisa's puppy house is dirty. Lisa's puppy house is dirty.
Lisa puppy's house is dirty. Okay, Lisa's puppy's house is dirty. Okay, good. Next.
The school is owned by Sonny's father.
Okay, next.
This is my sister's school.
Good, next.
It's the boy's toy.
Okay, next.
The mansion is owned by Tony's father.
Good job. Excellent, Darren. Thank you. Very good. Alice? Your turn, baby. Let's go.
Yes, ma'am?
Let's go, your turn. Your turn, nak. Sekarang gilirannya Alice. Eli, ayo baca kalimatnya.
Oh, oke. Okay. Oh, suaranya
kadang. Iya, oke, okay, iya. Ini Miss Jessy soalnya lagi di kelasnya Mr. Rendra. Jadi mungkin agak enggak terlalu jelas, oke? Okay? Okay, let's go.
Number one, I think my
puppy yesterday. No. What number one? Pelan-pelan, sayang, pelan-pelan.
I think my puppy yesterday.
I
keep my puppy yesterday.
I what, sayang?
I feed. F-A-E-D.
Oh, I feed. I feed
my puppy yesterday.
Ah. Itu possession-nya bukan pakai my. Bukan pakai my, tapi pakai apostrofi s. Jadi kalau kamu bilang seperti ini, itu akan lebih baik. I feed yesterday ya, berarti pakai fed, bukan pakai feed. I fed my brother's puppy yesterday. Itu baru benar. Oke, okay, Alice, I fed my brother's puppies yesterday. Oke, okay, next, Alice.
Number two, I go to school with my car.
I go to
school with my car.
I go to school by car. Oh, aku pergi ke sekolah naik mobil. Oke, okay, gini, I go to school with I go to school with my friend's father misalkan. Jadi kamu diantarkan sekolah itu oleh papanya temanmu, gitu, or gitu, bisa. So I go to school with Lisa's father, misalkan. I go to school, berarti kamu sama temanmu diantar sama papanya, gitu. Jadi karena kalau yang pertama itu kamu tidak menunjukkan kepemilikan, gitu. Or this school is owned by my my friend's father, itu baru bisa, ya. Okay, next.
Number three, there was a lot of books in my friend's house.
There are a lot of books in my friend's house. There are a lot of books in my friend's house.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh ya, penthouse kayak layangan putus ya. No, no, you don't show any possession there. Itu nggak menunjukkan possession, nak, di sana, nak. Jadi bisa dibilang seperti ini. Uh, There are lots of books in my friend's penthouse. Itu baru bisa. There are lots of books in Erica's penthouse. Nah, itu baru bisa. Ya. Menunjukkan kepemilikan. Okay, next. Alice.
Number 4, there was a boy feeding his cat.
Hah?
There was a boy feeding his cat.
Okay. Tidak ada, sekali lagi tidak ada possession-nya. Nah, misalnya tadi minta bikin kalimat yang memiliki unsur possessive form. The boy's cat is being fed by his mother, misalkan. Jadi kucingnya, anak laki-laki ini sedang dikasih makan oleh mamanya. Mungkin bisa. The boy's cat is being fed by his mother. Oke, okay. Itu baru bisa. Jadi menunjukkan kepemilikan, show some possessive form. Dari tadi itu belum ada. Oke, okay, next, Alice.
The house is theirs and it's painted beside
him. The house is theirs. No, kita belum nyampe ke theirs, belum sampai ke possessive pronoun. Kita masih pakai apostrophe S. This is my uncle's house. Itu baru bisa. This is my uncle's house. Itu baru bisa. Oke, okay, Alice?
Oke.
Okay. Joshua?
Yes.
Yaton.
Api. Ben have a lot of puppies.
Eh, wrong. Itu enggak ada kepemilikannya, Nak. Siapa tadi yang punya anjing banyak tadi? What is your first sentence? Apa itu kalimat pertamamu tadi apa? Kalimatmu barusan apa, Joshua?
Puppies.
Iya, kalimat. Kalimatnya bagaimana?
Ben have a lot of puppies.
Ah, itu tidak menunjukkan possessive form yang menggunakan apostrophe S. You can say these are Ben's puppies. Ya, these are Ben's puppies. Ini adalah anak anjingnya Ben. Gitu. Oke. Okay? Number 2.
I must go to school at 7 a.m.
Wrong, enggak ada penunjukan possessive-nya. Tidak menunjukkan keposesifannya, kepemilikannya tidak ada. Bisa seperti ini, my brother, this is my brother's school. Or my brother's school starts at 7 a.m. Itu baru bisa. My brother's school starts at 7 a.m. Itu baru bisa. Jadi sekolahnya saudaraku itu mulainya jam 7. Itu jam 7 pagi maksudnya. Oke, Joshua, nanti diganti ya. Next.
My brothers have so many collection of books.
Okay. My brother's books collection are in his room. My brother's books collection are in his room. Itu baru bisa. Kalimat itu belum menunjukkan possessive form sama sekali. Oke, okay, next. Josh.
That is kept for the boys.
The boys' cats are cute. Bukan that is cat of the boys, bukan seperti itu. Jadi tidak menunjukkan kepemilikannya seperti tadi. Jadi kalau kamu mau pakai kata boys dan kucing, kamu bisa bilang the boys cats are cute. Jadi anak-anak apa kucing dari anak laki-laki itu lucu-lucu gitu. The boys cats are cute gitu. Oke, okay, next.
My parents want buy me new house.
Huh?
My parents want buy me a new house.
Okay. My parents' new house is bought for me. My parents' new house was bought for me. Jadi rumah barunya orang tuaku itu dibeli untuk aku, gitu. Ya, or this is my parents' new house. Oke, okay, bisa seperti itu. Oke, okay, Joshua nanti diganti ya, Nak. Next. Email. Email.
Ya, Mem.
Ya, your turn.
Number one, puppy. Linda have a lot of puppies.
Wrong. These are Linda's puppies. Or these are Linda's cute puppies. Baru bisa. Next. Next.
Number two, school. Maya's dad is the principal in the school.
Maya's dad. Who?
Maya's dad.
Can you type it on the chat? Maya's dad. Okay. Maya's dad. Maya's father. Supposed to be Maya's father is the principal of the school. Gitu kan?
Yeah.
Yeah. Jadi dad-nya diganti father ya. Maya's father is the principal of the school. Okay, next email.
Number three, book. Octavia's book is happy.
Huh?
Octavia's book is happy.
Octavia's book is happy. Bukunya Octavia itu bahagia, itu maksudnya.
Happy.
Okay. Ophelia's book is happy. Good. Next. Next email.
Number four. Boy. The boys are playing game together.
No. Possessionnya nggak ada di situ. Posisinya enggak ada di situ. Oh, you can say Mobile Legend is the boys' favorite game. Bisa. Mobile Legend is the boys' favorite game. Jadi Mobile Legend itu game favoritnya anak-anak gitu. Oke, okay? Diganti gitu ya email ya. Next email.
Number 5, house. Yin buy two big house.
Siapa? Bill.
Yin buy two big house.
Bill ya, B-I-L-L. Siapa Imelda? Siapa yang beli rumah?
Yin.
Jin?
Yin.
Huh? Who is that? Siapa nak? Can you type it? Huh?
Jin.
Jill?
J-I-N.
Huh?
J-I-N.
Yin, oh my goodness. Yin buys. Yin buys.
Two big house.
Yin buys two big house. Yin's new house is big. Itu baru benar. Yin's new house is big. Itu baru bisa. Thank you, email. Jason. Jason. Ayo nak.
Number one, Papi. Jadi, Papi is okay.
Jason bisa lebih kenceng gak suaranya?
Johnny, Papi is okay.
Johnny's puppy is cute. Okay. Johnny's puppy is cute. Okay. Next. Jangan lupa setelah Johnny itu pakai apostrofi S loh ya, Jason.
Oh iya.
Ya, okay. Johnny's puppy bacanya adalah Johnny's puppy is cute. Boleh. Next. School.
School. And this school is something.
Okay. Candy's school is?
Big.
Okay. Next.
School. Candy's school.
Huh?
Candy's school.
Okay, good. Next.
Boy. The boy is big.
Huh?
The boys are
sorry. The boys are sorry. Mrs. Singa, dengar dengan jelas. What is that? The boys are
storage.
Storage?
Yes.
Can you type it? Can you type it on the screen, please?
The boys are storage.
Oh, the boys are so rich. Posisinya di mana? Posisinya di mana? Menunjukkan yang menunjukkan posisinya di mana? The boys.
Oh.
Ya. Ya kan? Bisa dibilang the boys. The boys. The boys. Apa? The boys' cars are expensive. Itu baru bisa, ya. The boys' apartment are big. Misalkan gitu, ya. Oke, Jason, next. Jason.
Henry's house. Big and cool.
Ya, yeah. Henry or Henry's?
Henry.
Posesinya di mana? Kalau kamu nggak pakai S, kalau kamu nggak pakai apostrofi S?
Di Henry-nya.
Hah?
Di Henry-nya.
Nah, so how to say or how to read is Henry's house is apa tadi?
Henry's house. Is
big and cool. Yeah, good job, Jason. Very well. Excellent, ya. Yeah? Good job. Jack Sky.
Number one, puppies. In my brother's house, there are so many puppies.
Good job. Next.
Number two, school. My school is near with my house.
My school. Itu diganti nak. My brother's school. My brother's school is near our house. Gitu ya. Oke, Jeff. Jeff.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, next.
Number three, book. This is my brother's book.
This is my brother's book. S-nya harus dibaca dong. Ulang. Can you repeat, Jeff?
This is my brother's books.
My brother's books. Jangan lupa setelah brother itu kan apostrofi S, itu harus dibaca. Karena kalau enggak, orang enggak ngerti itu kepemilikan atau bukan. So, this is or these are my brother's books. Gitu. Coba ulang, Jeff.
This is my brother's book.
Okay, this is my brother's book. Bukunya cuma satu ya. The book is only one?
Yes.
Okay, good. Next.
Number four, boy. This is boy's pencil case.
This is the boy's pencil case, okay. House?
Number five, house. In this house are so many cactus.
So many what?
So many cactus.
Crackers?
Cactus.
Cactus?
Yes.
Okay, possessionnya di mana? Because it doesn't show any possession there. Posisinya di mana?
In Jack's, this house.
No, Jack's house has lots of cactus. Itu baru bisa. Jack's house has lots of cactus. Jadi rumahnya Jack itu ada banyak kaktusnya. Or there are lots of cactus in Jack's house. Itu baru bisa. Okay? Thank you, Jeff. Now we go to Axel. Axel. Axel.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Silakan kalimatnya, nak.
Puppies. I leave my...
Wait. Puppies. It's not puppies. Dari tadi temannya dari tadi ngomong puppies loh ya. Kamu dengarkan apa enggak? It's puppies, not puppies. Let's go.
Puppies. I leave my puppies at the neighbor.
Enggak menunjukkan possession itu. My sister's puppies live in a kennel. Kayak gitu. Jadi anak-anak anjingnya saudariku itu tinggalnya di kandang anjing, itu baru bisa. My sister puppies live in a kennel, itu baru bisa. Nomor 2, nomor 2, Axel.
School. My brother, we go to school every day.
My brother's school is far from home. My brother's school is far from home. Sekolahnya saudaraku itu jauh dari rumah. Itu baru bisa. Itu baru benar. Nomor 3. Diperbaiki ya, Axel ya.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
I booked today ago.
What? Axel, gimana maksudnya?
Ini bacanya gimana, ma'am?
Coba, bahasa Indonesia-nya gimana, nak? Bahasa Indonesia-nya gimana, nak?
Diketik aja ya, ma'am, ya. Yeah. Itu bacanya gimana?
Bot. Bacanya bot, B-O-T, bot. Coba ulang lagi. I bought a book 2 days ago.
Iya, ma'am.
Itu enggak ada kalimat kepemilikannya, nak. Yang pakai apostrofi S gitu loh. Oh my god. Gini aja deh. This is my brother's book. Itu udah paling gampang deh. This is my brother's book or this is my father's book. Or this is my mother English book. Itu baru bisa. Okay, Axel. Next.
Boy, what did the boys do at break time?
Okay, next.
House. At my house, there is a family event.
Di rumahku ada acara keluarga gitu ya?
Iya.
Today is my family's event. Or my family's event is is on Monday. Misalkan my family's event is on Monday. Or my family event my family's event is on Sunday. Jadi acara keluarga itu ada di hari Minggu. Itu baru bisa. Oke?
Oke, ma'am.
Thank you, Axel. The last but not least, Kevin.
Papi, your papi is so many.
Your papi is so many. Oke, Jacob's papis are many. Itu baru bisa. Oke, next.
Your school is pretty good school.
Jake's school is a good school. Jake's school is a good school. It's a great school. Itu baru bisa. Next.
At school, in the library, there are a lot of books.
Ya, at least Miss Desi ngerti bahwa kita harusnya selesai jam 11. But, look at your friend, mereka belum selesai semua. Sabar ya. Oke. Okay. Kevin, next.
Boys seem to be playing football.
Next. Huh? Ya, kasih tahu aja. Terus, next.
Lagi, kan?
No. Next. Lanjutkan.
Selanjutnya atau lagi, Miss?
Kamu terakhirnya tadi apa? Kata apa tadi terakhirnya?
Yang boys itu.
Oke, ulang lagi boleh?
Boys seem to be playing a football.
Next. Selanjutnya, house.
I went to my friend's house.
Ya, oke, okay. Next. Thank you, Kevin. Ini leader tidak ada, Rahel bermasalah wifi-nya, and then Simon, Miss Desi nggak tahu kemana.
Simon, Ben.
Oh ya, Simon. There you go, Simon. Ada Simon ya?
Tadi keluar masuk Zoom terus, Ben. Nggak bisa saya buka.
Oh, oke. Ini sekarang sudah bisa ya, Nak, ya?
Sudah lumayan.
Oke, let's go. The last one. Yo, untuk Simon.
Nico Papis Armeni.
Oh, Nico Papis Armeni. Good job. Next.
Brian don't want go to school.
Brian
don't want go to school.
Brian tuh pakai doesn't. Brian's school is far, so he doesn't want to go there. Itu bisa. Bisa ya, misalkan seperti itu. Brian's school is far, so he doesn't want to go there. Itu baru bisa, oke? Okay? Karena menunjukkan kepemilikan. Next. Simon.
This is Nico Books.
Yes, next.
Number 4.
The boys
are playing game.
The boys game. The boys game atau permainan anak bisa. The boys games are rough. Misalkan gitu, permainan anak laki-laki itu agak kasar. Seperti sepak bola atau sepak takraw atau volley gitu ya. Jadi bukan the boys are playing game itu tidak menunjukkan posesif atau kepemilikan. Seperti contoh-contoh yang sebelumnya, Mobile Legends are the boys' favorite game. Itu baru bisa. Oke, okay? Simon.
Oke. Okay.
House.
Brian's house look like a ghost.
Brian's house looks like
a ghost.
Okay. Alright. Thank you, Simon. So everyone, you did great. Jadi catatan untuk beberapa teman-teman ya, beberapa anak-anak, ada yang masih tidak menggunakan possessive. Ya, masih ada yang tidak menggunakan possessive form dengan apostrophe S. Masih ada yang tidak mengerti. It's okay. Nanti Miss akan explain lagi. Atau kalau kalian mau mendengarkan penjelasan, nanti bisa putar atau cek di YouTube sekolah. Nah, itu saja. I think that's all. We will close our lesson today. I'm so sorry if it's a little bit late than usual schedule because your other friends still struggling in this material, okay? Who's gonna pray today? Ayo, siapa yang memimpin doa? Silakan. Loh, gak ada yang mau pulang ini? Gak ada yang memimpin doa? Ayo, kalau mau end, memimpin doa dong. Yo, hello, anyone? Hello, guys, pimpin doa yuk, Mak. Let's go, anak-anak.
Erika.
Okay, let's go, Erika.
Teman-teman, mari kita bersatu dalam doa. Tuhan Yesus, terima kasih sudah memberkati kami sepanjang Zoom. Sekarang kami mau selesai Zoom, berkati agar kami bisa mengerti semua yang telah kami pelajari. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, amin.
Amin. Okay, thank you for today. I see you guys next week. God bless you all. Bye-bye.